Hi, this is Bee from Sorcery Soap, and we're going to make some animal cones today. Sally suggested in the Patreon group that she wanted to see some zebras. Some of the things you're going to need are gold, white, and black. And the black needs to be in an extruder. I'm going to change the end of this first before we get started. So right now I'm rolling out the gold. I'm going to leave that because I want that to be ready when I'm ready. And it gives me an idea of how big I need to make things. So this is a triangle, obviously. It's kind of a munged up triangle. Apparently I've touched it a couple times since I pulled it out. And I'll show you. This is the case with soap on it and a whole host of other things, dust probably. Anyway, it's one of my favorite go-to tools for shapes. And the thing about shapes, you can cut all this stuff out with a knife. So these are all, it's a Teco, and you can get them on Amazon, I don't know, 20 bucks maybe. They're totally worth every cent. I use them on a regular basis. And so the thing about shapes is it helps keep you, give you a standard essentially. So then you can sort of uniform things, you know, at least that they're gonna be, you know, the limit of my size is how big I want them on a bar. Essentially, I'm going to start off with the body part. Well, that'll kind of indicate how big the head is, because this also is a rough idea of how big my I want it to be for the bar of soap. So we'll just make a sort of cone-ish sausage. You can see that I'm using this. And this doesn't have to be very big, actually, because we want it to be inside. Going to make the zebra slash horse head, which is essentially that's what it is. And they're all sort of looking down, so their eyes look forward. It doesn't need to be too big. I feel like I made it a little bit too big on the picture in the book, because these cones are in the picture. There's a giraffe, a panda, a dragon, which I've made a video of, a unicorn, a elephant, zebra, lion, and then a mouse. Let's put his eyes in. He'll be able to see him a bit. I want his eyes to be sort of big and forward facing, so I think that's the nicest part about a horse is their eyes. One of the nicest parts besides their nose. Their nose is quite nice too. So you can see how his eyes are a little bit forward. We just want to put a little bit of water in there so that I said a little bit and then I drowned it. I could take that out. And I'll give it a spray when I'm done too, because if you put water like this, you leave little bubbles that you can't really see right now, but taking a picture of them, I'll see those bubbles. And if I spray it, then I can't put this on there. Because alcohol doesn't let soap dough stick to each other. As much as people say that that's the melt and pour thought process, it's not true. It just gets rid of, it creates a layer is what it does. Okay, so I want to put his ears on first, I realized, because otherwise I won't know where to put things. So, and I was looking at him, and I think that, like, so I'm going to make a little pocket to fit his ears in, right behind his eyes. Now, the other thing I think about these ears is that when I make soap, I don't want things to break off. So I'm going to set his ears in, so when he sets down, he sets more flat, and his ears are going to be out flat. So one of my favorite ways to make ears is just make a little ball and then give them a pinch and pull them apart. And that starts the idea of the ear like that. So, and I never want them to be too, unless they're going to be flat, they shouldn't, for me, I won't make them too pokey like that, because that'll just break off eventually, and then I'll be left with a design that I didn't intend, and I don't really want that. So, let's see, right like that, yeah. Okay. So this ear I like a lot. I'll give him a little cut right like that, and then cut all that off. Okay. And all this is like, it all is delicate. You know, it's not like it could be soap dough, polymer clay. It's all like delicate work. Oops. We don't want pointy ears too much. But I want to make some attachment points on here. See, I need to let this dry just a bit before I keep handling it. And the other thing, too, that I realize is, like, oftentimes when I'm making soap dough stuff, the back doesn't bother me that it's messy. But on the clay, when you can pick it up and look all the way around, the back has to be all nice and tidy too. And that was like, well, didn't realize that. Just that kind of throws a wrench in my works, doesn't it? Okay, so they have kind of deep set ears. Not deep, but you know, these like, now I'm gonna let this set, even though you're gonna see me work on it pretty soon, I'm gonna let this set for about 10 minutes just to let it solidify a bit and dry, so then I can handle it, because I'm gonna put those stripes on. See how it's starting to pull up from itself? And I'll cause myself a lot of consternation if I continue with this, so. Okay. So we're back. I've let this dry just a bit. It's a little bit still wet on the backside. And we won't need to see the backside very much. And then, so this is, I just have these little things to make the cone. Yeah, it's all kind of like, you know, whatever I have at hand. I just want a little bit of the waffling. I don't really care if it's, I'm gonna put it back. I'm gonna do it again, so I'll show you. I just wanna make sure it fits before I put water on it. And there, I'll just move that up a bit so it covers that seam. And then this is also going to, let's see, I'm gonna tuck that under there a bit. And as I'm doing this, I'm getting rid of the waffling part, but I'll put that back on. Because the more I handle it, the waffling part comes off, but... There. I like that little tiny detail. Okay. And we're going to put his legs on, too, because I always forget the legs. Now let's put some stripes on him. See how that goes. See how that goes. So I like a stripe right down the middle of his forehead. My picture, I put a lot of different stripes on there. I don't know, I need that many stripes on this one to get the point across. Plus he's a little bit smaller than the one I put in the book. So there you go, there's your zebra. Anyway, I hope this helps. And if you have any more comments or suggestions of things you want to see faster than what I can, you know, what I'm thinking or the process I'm thinking, I'm happy to do this. This video came because Sally said that she'd like to see the zebra cone. And then I said something about the giraffe, so I thought maybe I'll work on the giraffe next. And, or if you want to see something else I've done that I'd be happy to show you, and just leave it in the comments and I'll definitely consider it. So thanks for watching and I hope this helped. Okay.